Cody here. We're heading up to Chicken Hole Base once again. You can see it is dark. It's only about 7 o'clock, but it is winter, so it gets pretty dark fast. But up ahead, you can see a little light. That's actually something I set up last time I was here. It's one of those little solar lights that comes on when it gets dark. It's sitting up on the cliff next to the chicken hole itself. It's kind of nice to be able to see it from a great distance.
Well, here we are. You can see the light up there on the hill. I've got my truck here with a load of a carbohydrate polymer composite, otherwise known as wood. I've got some water, a bucket of charcoal there. This charcoal is actually for my bees. You can see it's floating on top of some water. Figure the bees can get the water out of it. But it's going to snow tomorrow morning, so I need to get this wood under cover. And I think the best place to put it is inside one of these tanks. There, what's wrong with that? That'll keep it dry. Good. Okay, so I'm back. It's been a few days. I got another load of stuff. As you can see, I got a big tank in the back of my truck here. I guess you could say that's my fish tank. It will be part of the small greenhouse, the sump where all the water goes after going to the plants. You see, it did snow, got a couple of inches. Most of it has melted off though. It has been unseasonably warm. But that means that I didn't even need the chains to get my truck up here. All right. Let me get some stuff unpacked. So I got a bunch of these infrared trail cameras. I'm gonna go hide them around so I can catch any wild animals or trespassers that may be around. I'm not gonna show you guys where I place these. Okay, so as you can see, I brought out a solar panel, which I've just leaned up against this tree. And underneath of it, I've got a battery. This is a 12-volt DC deep cycle battery. I'll just stick that up there. A little tiny 100-watt inverter, which I'll put under there. And now, if I pull my phone out, there we go. I can charge the phone. Nice. Should be able to charge my laptop and other things just fine now. I have been using the car, you know, just the cigarette lighter, but that's kind of dangerous because if I accidentally run my battery dead, then I'm stuck here, but now I've got a whole separate system for that. So that should be good. Okay. Speaking of the phone, I did get a new one, and I'm using a different carrier now. So I should have no trouble getting on to Twitter. There we go, and tweet. Oh, probably can't see it. The sun's all weird, but there you go. You should be able to go onto my Twitter and see that. So I'm fairly excited. I've got internet now. I can take my laptop out, connect to a hotspot, and I should theoretically even be able to upload videos from here. Might take a while, but I can do it. Awesome. Also, standing down here, I'm not, you know, cut off from the rest of the world. I can actually call people. So that's huge. Since we got loads of melting snow, the bees probably have plenty of water, but when things dry out, they'll have this water bucket, which I've placed up in a tree, as you can see, just so the cows can't get to it. And and the charcoal so that the birds can't get in there and also the bees don't drown. I figure it was better than the styrofoam peanuts. Looks like the bees are buzzing around a little bit today. Not very much activity because it is still quite cold. You can definitely hear if I tap on them. Oh, yeah. They don't like that. Let's not do that. Cayuse is howling again. Sure you can hear him. I'm not too worried about him this time. Okay. There you go. Hole's now wider. See, I put down a drop cloth to catch all the microplastics. As you can see, I've left enough that I can bolt to it. And the hole's big enough that I just easily step through. Piece of cake. Okay, so here I am inside the tank. CO2 detector, which is showing 1,000 parts per million, which it's about normal for indoor spaces. I'm not too worried. This is a pretty big hole I cut there. I wonder what the best white balance to use in here is. Anyway, it's morning. My CO2 alarm never went off, so we're good. I spent the first night inside the tank. So, let's have a look at this compost. Smells like ammonia. Yeah, it's not that warm. Not much seems to be going on here. I think the main problem is that I just didn't have enough organic carbon. So, let's throw in some sawdust. The bird droppings I used were very high in nitrogen, and I'm thinking that the nitrogen levels are far too high, so hopefully the addition of some extra carbon will kind of help balance the levels out to what they need to be. Still, it is quite cold. It's warmer than it should be, but you know, we're still near freezing, so this will probably take a long time to compost. I may end up buying some compost. Hopefully I can find stuff that doesn't have any seeds in it, because I really want to avoid getting weeds. So I'm hiking around on the chicken hole property, and there's just this one lone tree that's been burned. You see there's some scorching on the tree next to it, but that's about it. There's nothing on the ground, the grass is all intact. The leaves are still on the juniper. So this must have happened this year. Either somebody intentionally lit it, or this is a lightning strike. See, the bark is pretty broken off. It might have been a lightning strike. It just didn't turn into a forest fire by some miracle. Since I still have the saw and have some battery power left, I figured I'd trim a few trees. See, it's not much. And now the tree is much less likely to catch fire. No branches hanging down touching the grass. Okay, well, that's about all I've got for you today. And I guess in the next episode, hoping to have some kind of structure. at least mostly built. Don't know if I'm going to do chicken coop or greenhouse, but I'm going to do something. So, until then, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.